Hello everyone and welcome back. Today I'm going to be working on this little, I call it the little winds page in Johanna Basford's Worlds of Wonder. And I want to do these little toadstools. And it's a nice and quick one to do. I think this whole video will probably be done in less than half an hour, I think. So it should be quick and easy to follow through. I want to use lots of earthy tones with this and I hope you enjoy following along. I'm using all Polychromos pencils for this. I have the 120 set and I will predominantly be using the very bottom tray, which is what I call the earthy tray, as well as a couple of pencils from the green range and one extra red from the top tray, but that's all you're gonna need. As you're getting your pencils out, just leave them out because I'll be reusing and using them over and over again. I think I'm using about two or three different shades of green, a couple of shades of red, and a few shades of the ochre and sort of Naples yellows. So leave them out and you'll be using them all throughout the page. Now I am going to go over with a few more layers of the reds, but I'm going to start now with the walnut brown and just add in some shaded areas. So as you can see, I've got the light hitting up on the top left. So obviously my bottom right is going to be my shady areas as well. I do love the walnut brown as well. I'm still on the grays to use shading rather than black. It's just softer and I can work it in better with my layers. Thank you. just going to go in here now and do one final layer with the middle cadmium red. It just brightens it up just that tiny bit, but I still have most of my earthy tones underneath, so it's not going to be too bright. My last video, you would notice that I love my terracotta. It is just the perfectly muted orange to use to blend between sort of my highlight and my red. I'm going to use the exact same two greens for all the rest of my greens for the entire picture. So just leave them out. Thank you. I'm going to start shading underneath just using this warm grey 4. I like using this one because it's not too dark, so I can sort of mark out my shading area first without that really, really dark contrast, and then I can build it up using the dark sepia in a little bit. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching this little toadstool video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please consider giving me a thumbs up, and I will see you again next time.